Figure 3 shows sketch of the circle C with equation x squared plus y squared minus 6x plus 9y plus 18 equal to 0. A, find the coordinate of the center of circle C, the exact value of the radius of C. Let us start to solve this part. So this is part A. So the equation x squared plus y squared minus 6x plus 9y plus 18 equals to 0. So x squared minus 6x plus y squared plus 9y plus 18 equals to 0. So x minus 6 divided by 2 equals to 3 squared minus 3 squared 9 plus y plus 9 divided by 2 squared minus 9 divided by 2 squared plus 18 equals to 0. So center of C, 3 minus 9 divided by 2. This is part II. But II. Now, x minus 3 squared plus y plus 9 divided by 2 squared minus, let us find this value, 4.5 squared minus 18 minus 4.5 squared minus 9. So minus 45 divided by 4. 45 divided by 4 equal to 0. So x minus 3 squared plus y plus 9 over 2 squared equal to 45 divided by 4. So r squared equal to 45 divided by 4. From here, r equal to square root of 45 divided by 4. Square multiplied by minus 1 equal to square root answer equal to 3 square root of 5 divided by 2. 3 square root of 5 divided by 2. This is part other one. Let us go ahead to another one. And intersected C at the point B and Q. Given that length BQ is 5. The static equation for L. So this is the line who is parallel to Y, and this point is point B, and this point is point Q, and this distance is 5. We need the equation of the line, this line x equal to something. So we need here the x of B and the x which is the same x in Q. So we can write here, this is x B and y B, no need for y, and here x Q which is equal to x B, and the distance here is yb plus 5. The coordinate of this point is yb plus 5. Okay? So the question here, we need xb which is equal to xq which is equal to the equation of this line L1. Okay? Let us start to solve. We know that this is the center of the circle, which is minus 3. Plus 3 and minus 9 over 2. So if we know this distance and we add this distance to 3, we get what? We get the x-coordinate of v and the x-coordinate of q. Let us assume this distance is x1. So this x1, this line from the center perpendicular to the midpoint, so this value is 5 over 2 and this value is 5 over 2. So from Fythagoras, and this line is the radius, which is square root of 45 divided by 4. So this radius square is equal to 5 over 2 squared plus x1 squared. Why we need x1? Because actually xb is equal to 3 plus x1. And q, xq is equal to 3 plus x1, which is this distance, the perpendicular one. And x1 is equal from Fythagoras, x1 squared plus 5 over 2 squared is equal to the radius squared, which is square root of 45 divided by 4 squared. So this is part B. So x1 squared plus 5 over 2 squared is equal to the radius squared, which is square root of 45 divided by 4 squared. So x1 squared is equal to square root of 45 divided by 4 squared minus 5 over 2 squared. So x1 squared is equal to, let us bring our calculator. So answer squared, answer squared minus 2.5 squared. 5. So x1 squared is equal to 5. So x1 is equal to plus or minus square root of 5. So now the equation of the line xb is equal to 3 plus or minus square root of 5. So the equation of the line, equation of L, x equal to 3 plus square root of 5 and x equal to 3 minus square root of 5. This is the answer of this question. Let us go ahead to another one. Find the first three terms in ascending the power of x of binomial expression 2 minus x divided by 8 power 7, given each term in the simplest form. This is the equation of the binomial. So the one we have, 2 minus x over 8, 2 minus x over 8 power 7. So let us take 2 as a common factor, power 7. 1 minus x divided by 16 power 7. So it's equal to 2 power 7, and then open the bracket. 1 plus n, n is equal to 7. So 7, 7 multiplied by minus x divided by 16 plus 7 multiplied by 7 minus 1 divided by 2 multiplied by 1 multiplied by minus x divided by 16 squared. This is the first C term. So it's equal to 2 power 7 plus 7 multiplied by 2 power 7 minus x divided by 16 plus 7 multiplied by 6 divided by 2 multiplied by 2 power 7 multiplied by x squared divided by 16 squared. So it's equal to 2 power 7, 2 power 7 128. So 128 plus 7 multiplied by 128 divided by 16. So minus, so 56 multiplied by minus x plus 7 multiplied by 6 multiplied by 128 divided by 2 divided by 16 squared. So 21 divided by 2 x squared. So the final answer 128 minus 56x plus 21 divided by 2 x squared. And this is the answer of this question. Now, f of x is equal to a plus bx multiplied by the r binomial equation, where a and b are constant. Given that the first two terms in ascending power of x in the series expression of f of x are 16, and find the value of b and find the value of a. So a and b, find a and b. Let us start to solve. This is part b and c together. B and c. So we have a plus b x multiplied by 2 minus x divided by 8 power 7. So we have a plus b x multiplied by, let us add this value, 128 minus 56 power x plus 21 divided by 2 x squared. Now, the coefficient without x is 16, so without x is 16, and another one, 249x. So without x, we have a 128a. So 128a will equal to 128a is equal to 16. So from here, a is equal to 16 divided by 128, 1 over 8. So a will equal to 1 over 8. And this is the first part. Second part, the coefficient of x. What is the coefficient of x? A multiplied by minus 56, so minus 56a. And then plus 128 plus 128b. This part is equal to 249. So 156 divided by a 1 over 8 plus 128b is equal to 249. So 128b equal to 249 plus 56 divided by 8. So b is equal to 249 plus 56 divided by 8 divided by 128. So b is equal to 2. And this is the answer of this part. Let us go ahead to another one. Find for theta bigger than 0 and less than pi the exact solution of the equation sine 2 theta plus 3 over pi, 3 pi over 8 equals to half. So you need it in radian. So we need to change our calculator to radian first. So shift and then radian 4. Okay. Now, this is part I, sine 2 theta plus 3 I over 8 is equal to half. So 2 theta plus 3 I over 8 is equal to sine inverse half. Sein Embers Hof. So, Chef sein minus 1. Find 5. So, this value is equal to pi divided by 6. And pi minus pi over 6. And 2 pi plus pi over 6. So, it's equal to pi divided by 6. And 5 pi divided by 6. And 12 plus 1, 13 pi divided by 6. Okay? So, 2 theta plus 3 pi divided by 8 equal to pi over 6. 2 theta plus 3 pi over 8 is equal to 5 pi divided by 6. 2 theta plus 3 pi over 8 is equal to 13 pi divided by 6. From here, theta is equal to 1 divided by 6 minus 3 divided by 8. So negative, so this is no solution. So here, theta is equal to 5 divided by 6 minus 3 divided by 8, 11 divided by 2. So 11 divided by 48, what? 11, 48, what? From here, theta is equal to 13 divided by 6 minus 3 divided by 8 divided by 2, 43 divided by 48 pi. So this is the answer of this question. Okay, let us go ahead. Now solve for x bigger than 0 and less than or equal to 360 the equation 5 sine x is equal to 4 tan x. Given your answer to one decimal place. So let us start. This is part B. The equation is 5 sine x, 5 sine x, 5 sine x equals to 4 tan x, and x is bigger than 0 and less than 360, so we need to change our calculator into digit or degree. So 5 sine x is equal to 4 sine x divided by cosine x. So 5 cosine x is equal to 4 sine x divided by sine x. So cosine x is equal to 4 divided by 5 multiplied by sine x divided by sine x. So from here, cosine x is equal to 4 over 5 and sine x is equal to 0. If sine x equal to 0 from this equation, so x, so from here x is equal to 180 and x is equal to 360. From here x is equal to cosine minus 1, 4 over 5. So let us find this value. Shift cosine minus 1, 4 divided by 5. So 36 point, how many decimal place you need? One decimal place, so 36.9. And we know that cosine is positive, Hier. So, x ist equal to 360 minus 36.9. So, x ist equal to 360 minus answer. So, 323.1. 323.1. This is x, and this is x, and here this is the 2x, if sine equal to 0. Okay, let us go ahead to another question. Now, a curve has equation y equal to x plus 2 squared multiplied by 4 minus x. The curve touch x-axis at point P and cross x-axis at point Q. State the coordinate of the point Q. So this is part A. Here, cross x-axis, we need Q, so y equal to 0. So x plus 2 squared multiplied by 4 minus x equal to 0. So 4 minus x equal to 0, so from here x equal to 4. Remember, x equal to minus 2 will give you b, but x equal to 4 will give you q, which is cross the x-axis. So q will equal to 4 and 0. And this is the answer of this question. Now, the finite region R bounded by the curve and the x-axis. Using a calculus so showing each step of your working, find the exact area of R. To start solve this question, you need to draw the curve. So, where is region R? This is our region R. From where I need from minus 2 to 4. So just draw freehand the curve so you understand how looks like your curve and the boundary start minus 2 and 4. But he don't need any graphical solution, he need the calculus solution. So area R, this is part B, equal to the integration of y dx from minus 2 to 4. Y is equal to, let us write the equation again, x plus 2 squared, x plus 2 squared multiplied by 4 minus x. 4 minus x. So it's equal to x squared plus 4x plus 4 multiplied by 4 minus x. So it's equal to 4x squared plus 16x plus 16 minus x power 3 minus 4x squared minus 4x. So it's equal to 4x squared was minus 4x squared minus x power 3. Here, 16x minus 4 minus plus 12x plus 16. This is our y. So area was equal to from my integration from minus 2 to 4 minus x power 3 plus 12x plus 16 dx. So it's equal to minus x power 4 divided by 4 plus 12 divided by 2x squared plus 16x from minus 2 to 4. So it's equal to minus 4 power 4 divided by 4 plus 12 divided by 2 4 squared plus 16 multiplied by 4 minus minus 2 power 4 divided by 4 plus 12 divided by 2 minus 2 squared plus minus 2 multiplied by 16. So area R will equal to, let us bring our calculator, minus 4 4 power 4 divided by 4 divided by 4 plus 12 divided by 2 multiplied by 4 squared plus 16 multiplied by 4, close the bracket, minus minus, and again open bracket, minus 2 power 4 divided by 4 plus 12 divided by 2 multiplied by 4 minus 2 multiplied by 16. So the area of R is 108, and this is the answer of this part. Now, using answer in part B and explain our reason, find the area of the finite region boundary by the curve whose equation y equal to 3x plus 6 squared multiplied by 2 minus half x and x-axis. So for the previous y and this y, here the previous y we multiplied by 3 squared, and the second part here we multiplied by half. So to start solve this part, which is part C, so x will be multiplied by 3 squared multiplied by half. So it's 9 by half, it's equal to 4.5. So new area will equal to 4.5 multiplied by 108. So it's equal to 4.5 multiplied by 108, 486. And this is the answer of this part. Let us go ahead to another question. Figure 4, so Blanche view of design for a stage at Chatfield. The shape of the stage A, B, C, D, E, F, A consists of rectangle A, D, C, F, join to two sectors of circle ABC. ABC is sector of a circle center A. FDE is a sector of circle center F. So the sector center F and center A. Given that AC is 2R meter, CD is R meter, angle DFE is theta radian, and the area of the stage is 30 meter squared. Show that the parameter b meters is equal to b equal to 4r plus 30 divided by r. 30 divided by r. Let us start to solve this part. We know that area of sectors is equal to half r squared theta. Okay. How many sectors we have? We have 1, 2. And we have the radius is 2r. And for the rectangle, we have r multiplied by 2r. This is area. So to start solve this part, area, which is equal to 30, is equal to r multiplied by 2r, which is a rectangle, plus 2 multiplied by half r squared theta. So it's equal to 2r squared plus r squared theta, take into consideration this r is 2r. So 30 is equal to 2r squared plus 2r squared theta. So from here, we have 30 is equal to 2r squared plus 4r squared theta. So theta is equal to 30 minus 2r squared divided by 4r squared, and this is equation number one. The second equation is the parameters. Here this is r theta, so 2r theta, and here this length is 2r theta. And here we have 2r, here we have 2r, and we have r. So the perimeter is equal to 1, 2, 2r, 4r, 6r, 6r, plus 4r theta. 4r theta. So let us write this perimeter. So the perimeter is equal to 6r plus 4r theta. We know theta from the top, so the perimeter is equal to 6r plus 4r multiplied by 30 minus 2r squared divided by 4r squared. 4, we have only 1r, so it's equal to 6r plus 30 minus 2r squared divided by r. So it's equal to 6r plus 30 divided by r minus 2r squared divided by r. This one, this one will give us 2. So the perimeter is equal to 4r plus 30 divided by r. And this is the equation they ask about. So this is the answer of this question. Let us go ahead. Use calculus to find the minimum value of b, given your answer in the form of a square root of b, where b, a and b are integers to be found. So we need the minimum value of the perimeter. To find the minimum value of the perimeter, so this is part B, we need the perimeter B is equal to 4r plus 30r minus 1. We need to dB by dr, which is 4 minus 30r minus 1 plus minus 1. So it's equal to 4 minus 30 divided by r squared. This value equal to 0 will give us the minimum value of r. So 4 minus 30 divided by r squared equal to 0 multiplied by r squared. So 4r squared minus 30 is equal to 0. So from here r is equal to 30 divided by 4, square root of answer, so half square root of 3, half square root of 30. So minimum perimeter is equal to 4 multiplied by square root of 30 divided by 2 plus 30 divided by square root of 30 divided by 2. So the perimeter 4 multiplied by answer plus 30 divided by answer. 4 square root of 30. So the perimeter minimum perimeter is equal to 4 square root of 30, where a is equal to 4 and b is equal to 30. And this is the answer of this question. Let us go ahead on. Now justify that the value of b found in part b is a minimum. So dB by dr is equal to 4 minus 30 r minus 2. So dTv divided by dr squared is equal to minus 30 multiplied by minus 2 multiplied by r minus 2 minus 1. So it's a positive 60 r minus 3. So it's equal to positive 60 divided by r or 3. So at r equal to, where is r? R square root of 3 divided by 2. Square root of 3 divided by 2. D squared b divided by dr squared is bigger than 0. So at r equal to square root of 30 divided by 2 is the minimum value of perimeter. Okay, let us go ahead to the last question. Given the first three terms of geometric sequence are 2 sine theta, 1 plus cosine theta, and 4 sine theta, show that 9 cosine squared theta plus 2 cosine theta minus 7 is equal to 0. So geometric series, so this is part A. We know that r is equal to the second one divided by the first one, and then the third one divided by the second one. So r is equal to 1 plus cosine theta divided by 2 sine theta and equal to 4 sine theta divided by 1 plus cosine theta. So from here, cross multiplier. So 1 plus cosine theta multiplied by 1 plus cosine theta is equal to 8 sine squared theta. 1 plus 2 cosine theta plus cosine squared theta is equal to 8 sine squared theta. We know that sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta is equal to 1. So from here, sine squared theta is equal to 1 minus cosine squared theta. So 1 plus 2 cosine theta plus cosine squared theta is equal to 8 1 minus cosine squared theta. So 1 plus 2 cosine theta plus cosine squared theta minus 8 plus 8 cosine squared theta is equal to 0. So 9 cosine squared theta plus 2 cosine theta minus 7 is equal to 0. And this is the equation that he needs. 9 cosine squared theta plus 2 cosine theta minus 7 is equal to 0. Now, given that theta is acute angle, find the exact value of cosine theta. So this is part B. We will add x equal to cosine theta. So 9x squared plus 2x minus 7 is equal to 0. So let us bring our calculators. So equation 3, 9 enters, 2 enters, minus 7 enters. So x is 7 over 9 and minus 1. X 7 over 9 and x equal to minus 1. So cosine theta is equal to 7 over 9. And this is the answer that we need. Okay? Let us go ahead to another one. Hence, find the simplest form of exact value of the first term of the sequence, the common ratio of the sequence. Let us start. The first term of the sequence is 2 sine theta. So this is part C. 2 sine theta. We know that sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta is equal to 1. So again, sine squared theta is equal to 1 minus cosine squared theta. So A is equal to 2 square root of 1 minus cosine squared theta. So it's equal to 2 square root of 1 minus 7 over 9 squared. 7 divided by 9 squared. So A is equal to, let us find this value, 2 multiplied by square root of 1 minus 7 divided by 9 squared. 8 square root of 2 divided by 9. 8 square root of 2 divided by 9. This is A. Now R is equal to 1 plus cosine theta divided by 2 sine theta. So R is equal to 1 plus cosine theta divided by 2 sine theta. So it's equal to 1 plus 7 divided by 9 divided by 8 square root of 2 divided by 9. So the common ratio R is equal to 1 plus 7. Plus 7 divided by 9 divided by answer. So the common ratio is square root of 2. This is the answer of this question, and this is the end of this exam. Good luck, bye.